Hey everyone, there's been an update to Natron, much to my surprise. I didn't actually know there was much of a team developing it, but it's good to see that there is. Natron version 2.4.0 has been released. There'll be a link for it in the description, or you can just jump over to the website and download it. It's free as per usual. I'm going to be taking a look at it today in this video, but before I do that, as some of you have actually told me, there are these plugins available for Natron called the Community Plugins. And they're basically just an extra set of nodes that you can install in Natron. And well, the more tools, the better, really. So I'm just going to quickly show you how to install those. They're not part of the update, but you might as well get these at the same time if you haven't already. So head over to the website, scroll down to where it says Community Plugins, click the link, and you can click this link here, or you can scroll down and hit this one here. It'll download a zipped file, extract that, and inside this folder will be this master folder here. You want to take that and put it here on a Windows and here on a Mac. On Linux, it's probably a similar file to the one on the Mac, but it will be somewhere inside the Natron folder probably. Relaunch Natron, and then you'll get this extra tab on the side here that are where the plugins live. These nodes will already be available for you in the tab menu as well. So you're good to go. You have all of these extra nodes to play with. And now to the Natron update. So unfortunately, I couldn't find any documentation or release notes specifically about this update. So I jumped into it and I was kind of just exploring what I thought might have been updated. I was mainly looking at performance or bug fixes and particularly rendering. I want this software to be much more stable when it comes to rendering. And I haven't done extensive testing, but from what I've done so far, it seems pretty good. It hasn't crashed on me yet. I did a pretty basic render test and it worked, which is great for Natron. So hopefully that translates into bigger scripts or just general stability. So to test the software out, I just made the thumbnail for this video. It's still a pretty basic script, but it's kind of about the average size of things I would do with Natron. It's just a couple of elements pieced together very simply. But it hasn't had any errors, it's working just fine, and I rendered it out, it worked the first time, no issues. I did a test with an actual video file as opposed to a still frame, and I tried rendering a MOV file, H.264. Hey guys, post-production Harry here. I need to interject here because I have found some weirdness rendering from Natron, but I also have a fix for it, so I'll show you what I've run into now. So this was the sample footage that I was using, and the test was just to import it into Natron, do a basic color correction, and render that file out and see if the file that appeared worked or not. And so when I did this, I got this result here. As you can see, the playback is completely broken, which is bizarre. And if I just play it in a different player, let's open it in VLC. It's not so much jumping back and forward, but it's still not playing smoothly, which is bizarre. But if I render it out as any other file, so if I just whip into media encoder here, and just make a copy of it, but an MP4, or I think anything works. I'll just render this out really quickly and open this here. Now it plays fine. If I bring it into Premiere, it also works. Just fine. It was bizarre, I noticed this when I was working with the broken file, and if I made a proxy of this file, the proxy would play just fine. So it seems like if you have a broken render from Natron, before you discard it, maybe just try converting it with some other software into something else, and maybe that will fix it. I don't know, I've never seen this issue before, but yeah, it's super weird. The EXR file from Natron worked just fine without having to do any conversion. I think it's a bit heavy to play here. No, yeah, so this I didn't have to convert. This is straight EXR from Natron, and it's fine. So a little bit of weirdness, but the rendering process still worked. It didn't crash, it didn't freeze, and the file worked. So yeah, I don't know, bizarre. But anyway, there's a little workaround for you. Back to the video.
But as I said, the EXR worked fine, and I recommend using EXRs when working inside of any compositing software anyway. So yeah, I was really pleased that rendering was smooth. I have done extensive testing, but so far, so good. So as I mentioned earlier, I couldn't find any release notes specifically relating to this update. If you know of some that I've missed, please put it in the comments below and I'll have a look at it. But seeing as I don't have that on hand at the moment, I can't go through all of the updates systematically. So this is very much just a first impression and kind of a notification to you guys that there is an update and it does seem better. Also to download the community plugins. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Go download the software, let me know what you think, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.